Hello everyone, my name is Clément Gignac, Senior VP and Chief Economist for our financial group. So over the next 5 to 7 minutes, I will try to summarize the webinar that we have just recorded for our advisor, so talking about the economy and capital markets. So the title of my webinar this month was, is it a justified optimism or risky proposition? So no doubt that people have some fear over the last few weeks, so people talk more about recession. So let's start with the good news. We have not increased our risk of recession, though the probability still remain around 30-35%, despite all the tension with China and even the attack that you have seen on Saudi Arabia, in fact, by a drone. So we will see. So yes, no doubt that we have a deceleration of the worldwide economy. In the manufacturing sector, as a matter of fact, we flirt a little bit with the recession. And even the earnings in U.S. On Wall Street are more about stagnation. But the good news is the fact that now we see the China who try to stimulate the economy. We have even in Europe, Germany, who has been very restrictive on the fiscal side. Now Germany is open-minded to use the fiscal tools to stimulate the economy. But the most important thing is this radical shift from the central banks. Now, central banks worldwide go with easing, with rate cuts, with stimulate the economy. So, of course, they have a transmission lag. The impact of these rate cuts will happen probably only later this year or beginning of this year. But the capital market is an anticipation market. So in such a situation, I think we have many reasons to remain optimistic. Talking about US anyway, when we check our dashboard, all our indicators suggest that, in fact, the probability of recession is pretty low. Keep in mind the consumer represents 2/3 of the U.S. economy, and they remain very, very confident. They have many reasons for that. The labor market, we have the full employment, and we have a pretty near record high on the stock market. So all in, we think that the probability of recession is pretty low, even if they have some region or they have some sector who have more difficulty. Talking about interest rate, we expect as soon as tomorrow, the Federal Reserve proceed with another rate cut. Probably you will see another rate cut before year-end. So in such situation, they want to really remove all the deflationary pressure that we have out there. In Canada, we have a very strong economy. In fact, if you check, for example, the labor market, this is the best sequence in 16 years. In terms of GDP, we have in the second quarter the best GDP growth in the G7. So I think things improve. Of course, this is more immigration-led because Canada accepts a lot of immigration, and that contributes, of course, of this wealth creation, and not to mention a booming in the housing sector. Talking about Canadian dollar, we think that since the Bank of Canada will be very reluctant to proceed with rate cuts, they have not big reason to proceed with rate cuts because they have interest rate lower than U.S. and they have inflation rate higher than U.S. So in such a cadence, don't be surprised that if we remain optimistic on Canadian dollar, 78, 80 cents by year-end. So do not be surprised that we edge our position in the portfolio that we manage, so with close to 5 billion assets under management. Talking about capital market, in fact, if you check different asset classes, they have performed very well since the beginning of the year, whatever is high yield, whatever is sovereign bonds, Canadian stocks, U.S. stocks, so they have performed very, very well. Looking ahead, we see some consolidation since that we have some uncertainty out there, and since we have, in fact, the earnings who are more sideways, I will say. But we don't believe it's the end of the bull market. We don't believe it's the end of business cycle. We think that we're heading to a prolonged business cycle. And in the circumstances, we think that the stock market will continue to have a new high in the coming months, or let's say next year. Anyway, what we propose is, since we are each different, so your risk tolerance, your objective investment is different. So what we invite you is really to consult your financial advisor, who could help you. In addition, we join to this Facebook or LinkedIn the material that you can consult. So on that note, I wish you a very good day.